And now let's see how things stood. The cat was perched on one branch of the tree. The bird on another. Not too close to the cat. And the wolf was padding round and round the tree, looking up at them with greedy eyes. Peter, without the slightest fear, was standing behind the lock gate, watching all that was going on. He ran into the house, fetched a strong rope, and climbed up onto the garden wall. One of the branches of the tree round which the wolf was walking leaned out over the wall. Getting hold of this branch, Peter climbed nimbly across onto the tree. Then Peter said to the bird, "Fly down and flutter around the wolf's head, but be careful he doesn't catch you." Almost brushed the wolf's head with his wings while the angry wolf snapped at him this way and that. The wolf. How the wolf longed to catch him. But the bird was too clever, and there was nothing he could do about it. In the meantime, Peter had made the rope into a lasso. And very gently lowering it down, he caught it round the wolf's tail and pulled with all his might. Feeling himself caught, the wolf began to jump wildly about, trying to get loose. The other end of the rope to the tree. wolf jumped, the tighter grew the rope around his tail. Some huntsmen came out of the forest. They were following the wolf's trail. Shouted from the treetop, "There's no need to shoot. We've already caught the wolf, the bird, and I. Just help us to take him to the zoo." Just imagine the triumphant procession. At the head, Peter. Behind him, the huntsman leading the wolf. Grandfather and the cat. grandfather still grumbling and shaking his head.
It's all very well, but what if Peter hadn't caught the wolf? What then, eh?
Above them all flew the bird, chirping merrily.
Oh, look at us, Peter and me. Look what we've caught.
If you listen very carefully, you can still hear the duck quacking inside the wolf, because in his hurry, he'd swallowed her alive.